Hello and welcome back to another electronic circuit analysis. For this BJT circuit, we are going to determine the output waveform in respect to the given input voltage. As you can see here, this circuit consists of one NPN transistor, a diode, and their biasing resistors. The input voltage Vi is a square wave signal and has two states, positive 5 volt and 0 volt. So we can study the circuit per input voltage levels. Let's assume we have a zero input, which means Vi equals to 0 volt. In this case, the transistor will remain off because its base emitter junction is not powered. So no current will flow through the resistor RB and base. The same way, there won't be any current flowing through the transistor's collector. Please pay attention how diode is connected to resistor RL collector and to the power supply through the resistor RC. As you may notice, the diode is forward biased, so there will be a current flowing from power supply through the resistor RC, RL, and diode to the ground. So by knowing this current, we can determine the output voltage due to zero input. Let's calculate this current with a simple KVL and rearrange it for finding the current we will have. Now, by knowing the current flowing through the resistor RL, we can calculate the output voltage. This is the output voltage due to zero input and when the transistor is off. Before we continue, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Your support will help this channel to grow and encourage me to create more content. Thank you, and now back to the video. Now we assume the input voltage is equal to positive 5 volt. As you probably noticed, this will forward bias the transistor base emitter junction and will turn on the transistor. In this case, we will have a current flowing through the resistor RB and base as well as collector of the transistor. Let's calculate the base current. Now we can also calculate the collector current since the transistor current gain beta is given. To calculate the output voltage, we need to know the total current flowing through the resistor RC. I said total current because there will be two different currents flowing through the RC. One is the collector current, IC, and other one is current flowing through the RL and the diode. We already calculated the collector current, so we need to determine the IL current in this new condition. IL is the current flowing through RL. This can be accomplished by writing a KVL from the power supply to the ground. Now, since we determined the current flowing through the resistor RL and knowing the collector current, we can easily find the output voltage due to input voltage by writing a KVL as follows. VO is the same as voltage collector to emitter in this case. Now we can draw the output voltage waveform in relation to the input voltage. For VI equal to 0, we have for VI equal to 5 volt, we will have 1.24 volts. If you enjoyed the video and found this channel helpful, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts under the comments. I appreciate your support.